Welcome to the UK Biobank Researcher Induction Course. I'm Dr. Lauren Carson, Head of Research Development for UK Biobank. This course is made up of six sections and will help you understand the basics about getting started with UK Biobank data. Let's begin with what is UK Biobank. UK Biobank is a large data set with extensive information on its participants. It comprises data from 500,000 men and women recruited between the ages of 40 and 69 years of age between 2006 and 2010. And at the time, they agreed to make all their health-related data available for research purposes. It is an incredibly deep data set with extensive information on participants' lifestyle, environmental factors, and biological factors, which then subsequently led to the development of various different diseases. The project has been running for over 20 years, so we have a long follow-up period capturing a large number of health outcomes post-recruitment. Data is accessible to any researcher, whether academic or commercial, who wishes to conduct health-related research in the public benefit. This provides a unique data set, which is unrivaled internationally. Over 10 million people were invited to take part, and 500,000 participants were enrolled into the study from across the UK. 22 UK Biobank recruitment and assessment centres were set up in England, Scotland and Wales to enhance the heterogeneity of the cohort. Biological samples, including saliva, blood and urine, were collected from participants, as well as data on lifestyle and environmental exposures, personal and family medical history, cognitive function, hearing and vision tests. Each participant gave consent for UK Biobank to access their health-related records and to contact them for further assessments during their lifetime. This timeline highlights the remarkable progress UK Biobank has made since the completion of the baseline assessments. We have successfully released both whole exome and whole genome sequencing data for all of our participants, along with a significant amount of imaging data. Our goal is to reach 100,000 participants with detailed imaging information. In addition, we have also released groundbreaking proteomics data for over 50,000 participants, further enhancing the depth and value of our research. Our epidemiology team have projected the potential disease cases within our cohort over time, based on national rates adjusted for the UK Biobank demographic. As shown here, we anticipate a rapid increase in key health conditions that are of great interest to our research community. For example, by 2035, we expect around 45,000 participants to be diagnosed with diabetes and approximately 35,000 to have experienced a heart attack. Similarly, we have calculated rates of stroke, various cancers, and neurodegenerative conditions such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease. And with regards to neurodegenerative conditions, we expect this to impact over 40,000 of our participants. How to access UK Biobank? There are several key principles to accessing UK Biobank data. All researchers accessing our data must be verified and registered with our access team to ensure that they are conducting research in the public interest. We prioritise equal access, providing the same level of access to both academic and commercial researchers, regardless of their position. Access fees are applied to cover the resource usage, not for funding the setup of UK Biobank. Access to biological samples is available but strictly controlled. More details are available on our website, including our sample release policy. Researchers should endeavour to publish their findings in peer-reviewed journals or as preprints, properly acknowledging UK Biobank. They must also share the data they generate with us for future use by other researchers. Access to UK Biobank participant personal data is covered by the principles of data governance as outlined in the GDPR course that researchers have already completed. Let's look at your application process in more detail. First step is to register using the Access Management System, AMS, and have your credentials reviewed by the Access team to confirm you are a qualified researcher. Submit your application, detailing your research goals and listing collaborators who also need to be registered with UK Biobank. Include a signatory for your Material Transfer Agreement, MTA, which is the legal agreement between UK Biobank and your institution. Internal review. UK Biobank will review your application and may request adjustments to fully understand your research proposal. Approval. Once your application is approved, payment and signatures for the MTA are received, and training is complete. Access the data is via the UKB research analysis platform and begin your research. To help make your application process as fast and smooth as possible, it's important to note the following information. The Material Transfer Agreement, or MTA for short, is the agreement between the Institute and UK Biobank. This has to be signed by the applicant institute and collaborating institutes where applicable. We have one material transfer agreement per project per institute listed on each project. And the terms of our MTA are non-negotiable. And we ask that you sign these electronically via DocuSign. With regards to the payment of application fees, this can be paid online through AMS or via BACS, where you can generate an invoice within AMS. Payment is to be made in British sterling, and it is not UK Biobank policy to complete any supplier forms you may have. Here are some top tips to reduce your application times. Ensure your legal team has seen our standard MTA at the point of applying. Amend your application in response to our feedback as soon as you can. Pay the access fee online via AMS. Please liaise with your finance departments to resolve any issues with online payments to ensure your payment is prompt. Sign the MTA we send to you and your authorised signatory via DocuSign as soon as you can. Costs and funding. UK Biobank uses a tiered approach for accessing data, tailored to different research needs. Tier 1 for projects that only require the core dataset, which includes information from questionnaires, physical measurements, health outcome phenotypes, linked health data, and web-based questionnaires completed by the participant. This tier is priced at £3,000 for 3 years of access, with the option to extend on a pro rata basis. Tier 2 includes everything in Tier 1, plus additional data like biochemical and hematological assays and other enhancement measures. This tier costs £6,000 for 3 years of access. Tier 3 provides access to all available data sets, including imaging data, whole genome sequencing, and whole exome sequencing data. This tier is set at £9,000 for 3 years and includes access to all data fields that UK Biobank holds. Project extensions, after the initial 3 year period, projects can be extended on a pro rata basis. Collaborating institutes, you can add collaborating institutes to your project with an administration fee of £1,000 per institute. If the project is extended, the costs are increased by £500 per institute per year. Reduced rates. For researchers based in lower income countries or student researchers worldwide, UK Biobank offers a reduced fee of £500 for 3 years to encourage participation. Extensions are available at a reduced rate as well. If you are unsure which data tier you need for your project, UK Biobank offers a demonstrator that showcases the available data as seen here. All of our data fields can be explored on the showcase website, and each field indicates which tier it belongs to. For example, field 31 illustrates the UK Biobank sex ratio with 54% female participants. This data is part of tier 1, which includes core information. The showcase website allows you to explore every data field, providing details about the number of participants involved. As shown here, UK Biobank has slightly more female than male participants, and you'll also see that the associated cost for each tier, like tier 1 pricing for core data, such as participant sex. If you've applied for a tier 2 dataset but realise you need data from tier 3, don't worry. You can simply contact our access team, who will upgrade your tier and apply the appropriate fees. There are also billing and storage costs related to using the UK Biobank Research Analysis Platform. When conducting your analysis, you'll need to set up a wallet within the UKB wrap environment. Each researcher starts with £40 of UKB wrap credits in their wallet to use for analysis. Wallets can be set up for individual or organisations, allowing multiple users to share one wallet. You can estimate costs using the UKB wrap rate card, which can be accessed on our UK Biobank community page or our website. Spending limits can also be applied to these wallets, for better budget management. Please note, there's no charge for storing UK Biobank data dispensed to your project. However, you will be charged for any data you create, cloud computing you perform, and for downloads of any researcher-created outputs. This is a great time to highlight the Global Researcher Access Fund. This fund is designed to support approved researchers from less wealthy countries by covering the costs of their application. And this generous fund has been contributed to by AstraZeneca, Bristol-Myers Squibb, Johnson & Johnson, and Regeneron. Researchers who benefit from this program can access the entire UK Biobank dataset. Additionally, all UK Biobank researchers can receive support with computing costs through the UK Biobank Platform Credits Program. For more details, please visit our website or feel free to contact us. How to analyse the data. The Research Analysis Platform is an online cloud computing platform which allows researchers to access and analyse UK Biobank data from anywhere in the world. The UK BRAP is managed by DNA Nexus and is hosted by AWS and provides instant access to the latest data and includes a vast library of pre-installed tools to help you analyse the data. Researcher responsibilities. The final part of this training looks at what you, the researcher, can do to help you get the best from working with the UK Biobank data. The most important researcher responsibility is to keep the UK Biobank data secure. Your login details are unique to you and you must not share your login details with anybody. Only registered researchers can use the data. We also ask the following. To keep your details up to date, submit project extensions in good time so that your project does not expire. Provide UK Biobank with an annual report of how you are using the data. Alert us to publications at least 2 weeks prior to publication. Return derived data to UK Biobank at the end of your project. Next steps. You have now reached the end of the training video. The next step is to take the test and you'll need an 80% pass mark to succeed. Don't forget to complete all mandatory training. Once you're approved, you'll be ready to start analysing UK Biobank data. We'd also love to hear your feedback on this course, so please do feel free to get in touch. Finally, there's plenty of online resources to support you as you start to use the UK Biobank RAP. These include documentation and tutorials, Gitbook notebooks, webinars, and a collaborative community portal where you can exchange ideas, tips, and experiences of using the UK Biobank RAP. And remember, the UK Biobank Access Team is also on hand to support you every step of the way.